Welcome back. We're going to do another partial fractions problem today. This one is the integral of dx over x squared plus x. Okay, the first thing that I'm going to do is change this integral a little bit so that it's simpler. I'm going to take the dx out. I'm going to factor the denominator. So this is going to end up as 1 over dx. I took the dx out, and then I'm going to factor out an x in the bottom. So x times x plus 1. So I've simplified the problem, and it becomes apparent now that this is a good candidate for a partial fractions problem because we have two terms in the denominator. One is x, and one is x plus 1. So with partial fractions, again, the first thing we do is write 1 over x times x plus 1 on one side. We set that equal to a over the first term in the denominator x plus b over the second term in the denominator x plus 1. And we do that so that we can solve this equation for a and b. So the first thing we do, we multiply each of these terms by x times x plus 1. So you can see x times x plus 1, x times x plus 1, and x times x plus 1. So you can see here that if we do that, everything over here is going to cancel except for 1. So we have 1 equal. X is going to cancel here, so we'll be left with a times x plus 1. Plus x plus 1 will cancel here, so we're left with b times x. So you can see, if you want to skip this step here, you can just take the numerator, 1, and set that equal to a times one of the terms here in the denominator plus b times the other term. It doesn't matter what's multiplied with a and what's multiplied with b. You could flip these as long as you keep your a and b consistent. So you can skip this whole step and just go straight to this and make it easier on yourself. So we end up with this equation here, and what we need to do is solve for a and b. The way that we do that is by canceling out a first and solving for b, and then canceling out b and solving for a. So first, let's cancel out a. The way that we do that is set this right here equal to 0. So if we put negative 1 in for x, we'll have negative 1 plus 1, and that equals 0. And if this is 0, then we have a times 0, and a cancels out because it's multiplied by 0. So we're going to go ahead and set everything in the equation equal to negative 1 so that a will cancel. And we're going to have 1 equals, remember, a cancels because we plugged in negative 1 and this ends up being 0, and we're left with b times negative 1. Therefore, 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1, and we get b equals negative 1. So we solve for b. Now we need to solve for a, and the way we do that is by canceling out b. So what does x have to be to cancel out? What does x have to be? If we put 0 in for x, then b will cancel, right? B times 0 is 0. So let's go ahead and put 0 in for x. We'll have 1 equals a times, and we said we were going to put 0 in. So 0 plus 1 is just 1. And then, of course, this is going to be 0, so we can just leave that out. So we can see that a is going to equal 1. So we solve for a, and we solve for b. Now what we need to do is plug a and b back into this part of our equation here. And then plug that whole thing back into the integral. So we're going to have the integral of a, which is 1, over x, plus b, which is negative 1, over x plus 1 dx. So this is something that we can now take the integral of. We solve for a and b, we plug them back into here, and then we put this whole thing back into our integral. It's just basically a way of transforming the original problem into something that we can actually take the integral of. And the way that we do that is partial fractions. So now that we've got this, the formula that we need to use is this. The integral of 1 over x equals ln, or natural log, of the absolute value of x. This is a formula. It's a rule. You need to know it for partial fractions. Almost every partial fractions problem, at least the basic ones, end with you needing to use this rule. So you can see we've got 1 over x here. The integral of that is natural log of the absolute value. And we're taking one term at a time. So we're going to do this one first, and then this one. So the integral of this 1 over x is natural log of the absolute value of x. And then since we have plus a negative, we're going to do minus natural log of the absolute value of x plus 1. You can see that there. So the denominator always gets inserted into these absolute value brackets for this ln. And don't forget to add c to account for the constant. The only thing we have left to do, this could be our final answer. It is correct, but we can simplify this, and it's kind of nice to do so by doing this. So we'll have ln of the absolute value of x over x plus 1 plus c. And this is actually going to be our final answer. The way that we do it, whenever you have natural log the absolute value of something minus natural log of the absolute value of something else, it's the same thing as natural log of the absolute value of the first thing on the top and the second thing on the bottom. So the only requirement there is that that is a minus sign. If this is a minus sign, this one goes on the bottom and this one goes on the top, and you're left with ln, or natural log, of the absolute value of x over x plus 1. And then, of course, plus c, you can't forget about that to account for the constant. And that's your final answer.